Hello and welcome back to Ahriman Prophecy. I'll really express my gratitude to all of you who have been watching it. It has been a pleasure playing this game a long back, after a long time back. So thanks a lot and keep watching it. So we'll continue here. I've been refreshed my life from the inn, and the ball for Kandar Prince Edward would just continue for some time. So we bought the Templar sword there, and I also got a chain helmet for Devin, and he's a bit stronger now. So let's see what we have alongside Kandar, as our task is still to go to Devi Shrine, and we also need to get the blessed water for the haunted forest. So they are in line. So let's go forward. Okay, this is a dock for Kandar, and we don't have any ferries or boat that will lead us. So for now, I think we can leave that. And now we have two goblins. So there were one previously. Once you get back from the dock, you find two of them. And I've been trying this magic, but it's very important to get the right character at right time. Otherwise, you will end up with wrong character like this time. Jack has a special power of stealing, which he is. He's a thief. So he tries to find something or steal something. Sometimes it is beneficial, because from some characters he might find a couple of pennies or even 8 to 10 pennies, gold pennies from them, which is an extra, of course. So cross the bridge and head back to the east. You see the sign said to desert, and Witchwood Swamp is in the southern part of it, and Dithi Shrine, if you remember, that is our main task. So I already visited this place earlier, so that chest is open now. And this augur are actually strong. Augur are not easy to hit, as I told in the previous video as well. So it's good that you put up a sleep charm on them and then hit them, unless you are very strong enough. So currently we are at class 26, and it is still 27-28 is good enough to go down to Witchwood Swamp. It is very dangerous over there, poisonous over there. So let's go to the east first, Dithi Shrine. Let's see what there is in prophecy for us. That is our main task actually. So let's head over. So Dithi Shrine here. And it doesn't seem good. I can see a dead body over there, and it is all now a ruin. So the shrine is not in a good condition now. Okay, you find a corpse of a dead priestess. So what could have happened to this shrine? You were about to leave and never noticed a letter clutched to the priestess. Okay, there's a letter in her hand. The first of the light has perished. The fist of the light has perished. Sorry. Corruption in the air, in the place. Auron must be found. So Auron is some main character, I think. Unwanted thief one. So Auron, it seems like some important character that we need to find him. And Seafall. I don't know where it is right now. We don't even have any board or sign that tells us where Seafall is. We know there's a beach tooth, something like that, and old Seafall shrine that someone has destroyed with this shrine. Okay, so it is also a shrine like just like the Dithi Shrine, and so I think it would be not easy to find just like the Dithi Shrine. We went a long way back to find it. So I think important if you see that we don't have any of the goblins and the ogre over here now. So if you visit to the shrine and come back, we don't find anything. That's good. Okay, so I think next stop would be to the Witchwood Swamp. It travels for several hours. The grassy hills slope into a damp, humid, and it sounds very creepy. I can see, I can hear, sorry, I not see, hear this cricket sound. And I think I should wear my poison ring first. It won't be good to go to a poisonous swamp with lots of poison frogs and get poisoned. So let's wear on both of character. I mean, Jack already has, so Devin and Talia will wear on them. Okay, we are down here and let's try taking these frogs. Okay, one down. Am I still getting poisoned? Actually, I have got poisoned. So the poison ring doesn't work. Talia is poisoned, so I didn't wear a. I think I've. Okay, she doesn't have. Okay, I think I mistake Jack for Devin and Devin for Talia. My mistake. Okay, so let's wear Talia poison ring as well. I think I missed Talia and took Devin as Talia and Jack as Devin. So Jack already had a poison ring. I just re-equipped it. Never mind. So let's refill some of our energy back. Elderwood Swamp for mana point. It's good to have mana points on Talia, at least because she will help to regain some life from her spell of healing. So we can use that on Devin and Jack, the only two party member that we have right now. So the healing spell would actually give us like 25 of healing. It will take 20 mana points from Talia, and we can refill the mana points for her. So it is good if you have this mana points because they will get refilled. So if you don't have food items for regaining health, then it is good that you go with mana healing for them. Unless you are down with mana. So there's one more frog. So I'm not getting poison now. That's good. Masti. That's good that they're giving us shedding some masti. If you don't have a poison ring, avoid this, avoid this, avoid her, avoid her. I know, I remember. These old hexes are. They're not poisonous, but they. Put some curse on you. I don't remember exactly what the curse was, but I remember from my past experience these are not good. For now I think we are not that much strong to go for them. Let's go with these frogs first, and I will recommend a class of 28 all our characters to visit this place. Okay, this is a grave. You condemned to digging. Oh man, let me hit them or read them. I can do one thing at a time. So grave digging is also part of this thing. I know you found one in Elden, but that is not good to dig in on your place. So this Witchwood Swamp will have a lot of graves, and this works like just like the barrels you have. So you can't dig the graves easily, so you would need a shovel that will help to dig them. That will come in later part. I remember getting that very last time when I played this long back. So avoid this black robe ladies, witches, for some time, because they will. I remember they put some curse on you, which kills you. Basically, I don't remember if they kill you gradually or something like that. All right. And there's a barrel there. Did I get it earlier or not? Maybe not. One master life. And now we are 27, that is good. But Tavir and Talia 27 now. So it's good that. Good for this area. This crow is following us. I don't know if it hit us. Okay. So if you get lost here, best is to follow this dirt path in swamp, because this will guide you to the right place. The game gives you hint, like the new RPG. If you play good games like Resident Evil, or you're playing some good first person shooting, whenever you fall into a darkness, follow the light. That is a good hint to giving a right path. So always follow the light. So similar into this, follow the dirt path. If you remember Prince of Persia, they will give scratches on the wall that guide you, that you have to wall climb the your way. Similar it is in RPG, just that you don't get lost, hung up on one place. Okay. If you have poison ring, then I think the mastery is worthless, but at least don't fight these witches first. At least not for now, unless you are 30. Alright, I think that is a house there, and there's a witch, green color witch. You can stay the night if you would like. The swamp is dangerous, only 50 gold coin rest. So as you move forward to new areas, the inn cost actually get more costlier. You started with 15, then 30, and this Witchwood Swamp takes you 50 gold coins. Okay, I am trying to. This broom just spoke something. I don't know what it was. Let me see if this is a hint to something. I'm trying to catch it. It's playing cat and mouse with me. Come on, get the fuck here. What the hell? And all it says, this is such a waste of time. I thought it said something important, so let's follow it. That's all this is. Oh, this looks like a school. And there's a one more stair up there. The shelves are empty. Apprentice say, hey, I'm skipping a class. Oh, really? I'm not able to get these books to read. I think they are not meant to be read. And there's a ward, that's empty. Another one is empty. And there was a stair to go up as well, but let's just talk here first. Some charms, watch for the swamp hags outside of the witchwood. They would like to curse people. The same one which I was talking about. You get really weak, it's hard to defend yourself or fight. Only tonic can cure the curses. Okay, so we have a cure for it. We need to have the holy tonic. I also heard there's a hermit in the north who sells it. I think the person in the cave, if you remember, with the moldy cheese, he gave us one holy tonic. And we just bought one. We didn't know where it was being used. So this is, I think, the cure or remedy for removing the curse that old or the black rob hexes that give you. Okay, so nothing else here. This wards, let's see, it's empty. And it is empty. So I missed one floor on the top. Let's go there. There's a book pile, and somehow I can read it now. In the lower floor, I couldn't read. Okay, so this is something what witches do. You can learn about them. Hickle pie. The art of revenge. The witching order teaches its student hexes and all those things. The swamp witch is most devious of all the witch world, okay. Strong curses will sap your powers and leave you defenseless. So actually it shows you what the curse could do. Okay, there's one more witch over here. Welcome to the Witchwood Apprentice. What is this place? Wielders test to become witches and warlocks. Okay. So I'll just hold here. I'll let you know. So there are many guilds in this game. And last time I remember, I just got to learn witchcraft from her. And I couldn't learn any other in the future. So the viewers who are watching this, please remember. To become a wielder, I mean to become a witch from this lady, you have to first fight her, defeat her, which is not easy at this moment. So we would not go for it right now. But there are other guilds as well, where you will learn new things. So it's good to go through all of them and then compare the best out of them. Because once you join one, you can't go join another. 14-15 years back when I played this game, I remember the first thing I did was defeated her and became a witch for Thalia. And there was some priestess, there was a mistress, and I couldn't do anything else from there. So it's good that you... I'm late for the class. You are just outside the classroom. Okay, so... go through all of the guilds and I don't know if she's a witch or just a cat. I'm just playing with it. So again, as I told you, there would be many more guilds. Go through the guilds and once you compare them all, the strongest one you should join them. Okay, there's one floor over here. And lot many wards. Okay, got an ankh major. And nothing else. So let's talk to this. I'm cleaning out the tower. If you see anything you want, please tell me. Okay, so she's a merchant and we can buy some good. So he also sells holy tonic, which is 80. I don't remember how much that hermit took from me, the cave person took from me. I think 50 or 60. So unless it is very necessary, I don't think you should buy it from here. You should go to that person first and buy it from him. If you already have the pile of holy tonic with you, you don't need to get that here. Unless it is imported as it. So I have a leather armor which I can send, so I sell. And if you have too many mastery, then I think you can sell here, but you have a poison ring, which is good that you're not using it. Equipment submit tagger submit. Okay, guys, this is the point where we get our first update for Jack. I know you were very furious about this thing that Jack only has a small dagger and why didn't we buy anything for him. So this is here. We have a serpent sword as well and bone rapier for Talia, which I don't think is good enough for iron staff. But one important thing, black robe. You need to buy this for Talia. It's an armor for Talia, which is very strong, just like the golden armor for Devin. So I'll buy this serpent dagger for first thing. It is the best buy that I can do for Jack. Let's equip it. I think that is the second thing. Yeah. So serpent dagger is only first upgrade that we got for, and it has poison. That is very important. So you can poison your enemy with it, which will eventually kill him or gradually kill him. So the dagger that we had earlier was just 2 attack and this is 26. It is much better than what we have for Jack. At least it's a bit stronger. There's serpent sword as well. I mean, that is good. But again, we have a Templar sword for Devin. So I think serpent sword, if you don't have a Templar sword, if you haven't bought serpent Templar sword, if you couldn't afford it, then it's good to go with the access for the old bat who lives along in the western swamp. So okay, I remember one more thing. There was one witch who has been culprit of many things over in Witchwood, and she's damn strong, so you don't go on fighting her just now. It's better you, so yeah, I'll get back to it. So there are caves here, this cat will meow. Okay, so these are graves here which you will actually need shovels to dig them, so we'll come back to it when we have a shovel. And I just want a Templar sword. If you don't have a Templar sword, then I think you should go for serpent sword, which is good, better than iron sword that we had in Kanda, and it also gives you ability to poison your enemy, so that is good. So if you looking to gradually kill up enemy, at least I mean some extra damage, so that is good. But if a Templar sword is there, then I think that doesn't work. Okay, let's get here. Hilda, you met Daryl. We met Daryl. Yeah, Kandar. We met Daryl at Kandar. So the person I told you who will put a charm on you, the warlock, curse on you, not charm on you, but curse on you. I've been trying to lure him. So the letter that we read regarding Hilda. So she's the one, and that person has actually put a curse on her, love charm on her, and she's seeking revenge. I don't know if okay, I'm out of battery now, should be soon. So I don't think we have this task subtask assigned to us so soon, or if there is any task, but we'll get back to it. Nothing here, let's get out. Okay, there is one more house here. Let's go left first. There's a well. There's a cat. There's an empty barrel. And the witch is flying on her broom, which we can't talk to. Come on. Welcome to witch. Ah, damn it, you're a waste of time. I don't know why such waste of time happens this way. Griselda, have you seen my magic broom? I can't go to the class without it. Okay, we haven't seen your magic broom. And there's digging up graves is a fisher fingers is you need to shovel it. Okay, the barrel is sealed. Okay, we have something here, a poison ring. We got a poison ring. We already have it, so you can get one poisoning over here, and you can also buy from the merchant if you don't have them from Kandahar. So we already had bought that from Kandahar. If you haven't, if you're visiting this Witchwood first, then I think you should buy from it, or at least one you got here. So I will not sell this poison ring yet, because if there is one more character joining us, one more party member joining us later in the game, then it would be handy for him. Okay. Yes. Kill this frog. As one more. Now, if you see a green highlight on these dead bodies of frog, so that means that Jack has poisoned them with his dagger. So this is as I told you, serpent sword or this thing, Broomstick Express. So I think this is similar to what we 200 gold for Kandahar. I mean, this is damn expensive, man. Are brooms expensive than the mules? It's a risk of flying on a broom if you don't have a good balance. Not mule. I don't know why brooms are more expensive. Okay, so we might need to find a broomstick for I think I didn't visit the house here, right? Yeah, let's get here. Okay, there is one. Someone has been stealing broomstick and torch from our ends. Apprentice, okay, so that doesn't sound good. There's a robber in at least it is not Jack, I can assure you. So I think this would be a side task to us, or maybe a good deed to us if we can find. This cat is not moving, not it is meowing, whatever it is, and all the wards are empty. So I don't know if it is a glitch, or if the cat is meant to not to move. It was intentional, and the broom will the same. Yeah, I knew it. So okay, this one, the first male that I look. Have you come to train as a witch? We have a bad stigma attached to our profession, but we are quite powerful. Okay, so it tells you about the guild, the witch. We can. I told you we are not that powerful enough yet to put a competition to that witch and defeat her, because that is what we have to. If we say yes to that witch, first we have to defeat her, and then we can join the guild. But again, I told you, if you join the guild, then you can't join any other guild. So just go through all the guilds first. Okay, so that's it. I think I'm already out of battery. So let's go to the inn, rest ourselves, and we'll take a tour of outside of Witchwood in the next episode. Okay, so we are refilled. So keep liking, and I'll just put a save as well. So as I said, I'd love to have your likes and your sharing. So keep subscribing to this channel, and let's build up this game. We finish this game series soon. So bye bye, have a nice day.